MSMEs were dismissed in one sentence, an allocation of 15,700 crore. This is like providing a fistful of votes to a hungry elephant. Nothing was mentioned about providing liberal, low-interest loans, working capital, or moratorium. Nothing will be done to revive closed units or to recover the millions of jobs that were lost. The FM seems to be unaware that thousands of MSMEs, especially micro and small units, have been closed permanently. A meager sum of rupees 20,000 crore has been set apart for recapitalization of public sector banks when the requirement is several times more. At the same time, the government intends to privatize two PSBs. The intent of the government is clear. Let the PSBs bleed slowly so that they can all be privatized in the short term. Let us see the reaction of the public to this unconcealed desire to sell off all public sector banks. The tax reliefs and the tweaking of provisions of the tax laws completely bypassed the tax-paying working class and the tax-paying middle class. Each one of the measures announced by the FM will benefit only the taxpayers among the richer classes. There was no cut in GST rates. The mess of multiple rates remains. The finance minister flattered me by quoting the same couplet from Thirukkural that I had recited in one of my early budget speeches. Maybe she had not been instructed by her staff that this kural has already been used in the budget speeches. She flattered only to deceive. She deceived the people of India, especially the poor, the working class, the migrants, the farmers, the industrial units that had been closed down permanently, and those who had lost their jobs, both regular and informal, and are still looking for jobs. She deceived those who were listening to her speech, especially the members of parliament, who had no clue that she had imposed cesses on a large number of products, including petroleum and diesel. Rupees 2.5 on petrol per litre and rupees 4 on diesel per litre is a cruel blow to the average citizen, including the farmers. It was a vengeful act against the thousands of farmers who took out the longest tractor rally in history. It was also a cruel blow to federalism, because the states do not get a share of the revenue from cesses. The point is, Mr. Narendra Modi and his party have won elections. I'm not denying that. But Mr. Narendra Modi and his party have also lost elections. They lost elections in Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, Goa, Manipur, Karnataka. So we have three ways of elections. You can win elections, you can lose election. They have invented a third method, stealing election. They stole the government from us in Goa, Manipur, and Karnataka and Madhya Pradesh. Therefore, just because a party wins elections in one year does not mean it has not lost elections in another year or will not lose elections in the future. But you should ask Mr. Modi. You should ask Mr. Modi. If you get a chance, please ask Mr. Modi on our behalf. No, you should ask him on our behalf. Why doesn't he care about the people? The farm sector has been shortchanged. The budget allocation for agriculture and allied activities has been reduced. I repeat, reduced from 1,54,775 crore in the BE of the current year to rupees 1,48,301 crore. In the BE of the next year. Of total expenditure, the proportion has been reduced, I repeat, reduced from 5.1% to 4.3%. The budget allocation for market intervention scheme and price support scheme has been slashed from 2,000 crore rupees to 1,501 crore rupees. The budget allocation for PM Kisan Samman Nidhi has been reduced from 75,000 crore rupees to 65,000 crore rupees. There are other important matters that the FM did not mention in her speech. For example, she did not mention defense at all, as if the Chinese had vacated occupied Indian territory. She did not mention that defense expenditure in 2021-22 will see no rise. It is flat at rupees 3,47,088 crore, almost the same as the rupees 3,43,822 crore in the current year.